Okay.
But he's the one who felt the guilt. I'm sure NASA did not feel that much guilt.
And, I mean, why did he go up, I wonder? I wonder why. Because they promised him a seat in 3 years when they figured it out. They kept lying about it being possible. So why do you think he did it? Why did Armstrong do it in the first place? He thought, they kept saying, we'll be ready in 3 years and you'll go then. Just lie now and we'll go in 3 years. The funding will keep going and we'll figure this out and you'll go.
Oh, actually go.
Right,
okay,
yeah.
Okay.
And they were lying, you know, yeah. And then he figured it out. And he got really, you know, so cynical. Got it?
Okay.
So why did Armstrong go? I mean, he was such a moral, principled man. Why would he go on a fake moon mission? I don't believe that.
Well, they strung him along because they led him to believe, oh, don't worry, we're going to have the money in a few years, and we'll actually go, and then you will go.
They'll have, of course, you mean they'll have the technology in a few years?
Yes.
Okay.
They will have enough, they will be able to actually perform the miracle of going to the moon. And yes, he would be in the saddle.
So otherwise, okay, let's make this clear. Kennedy set a deadline, psychological deadline of the 60s. They knew they couldn't beat it.
Right. But they could be great PR if they did.
Right. And if they did, you're saying they sincerely thought that they would really get there within a few years.
I believe, yes, they did think so.
Because that's what they, well, I mean, that's...
Although some didn't. There was a difference of opinion. There were some that just believed honestly that we will never be able to get there. There's just no chance.
That Werner and I used to, like, have coffee in the mornings, and he was like, that, you know, there's no fucking way. Like, you know, is it, like, you know, even Wernher von Braun.
Right.
So go. You want that? Some people didn't believe that you could go. Even,
well, Wernher von Braun, of course, didn't.
The director didn't think so.
The man was just too brilliant. He knew that we couldn't do it.
Okay. I'm talking about a guy working on two lost causes: the Nazism and you know the quest for the moon. I mean, he really did, and he didn't tell them. I mean, did he ever tell them? Did he tell NASA? Like, did he tell the president we can't go? I mean, he must have broke the news.
He was very old, of course, at the time, and a lot of people just dismissed him. Younger, more ambitious people, some of them really thought we could get there,
right?
Or wanted to believe it. Maybe on a conscious level, they knew we couldn't, but they just wanted to believe the impossible because they were so full of themselves
and so full of the dream.
Yes, the dream was very powerful.
And that's what beguiled Armstrong. Here is a noble, stand-up guy, and he didn't want to be part of the lie, but he knew he'd get a seat if he played ball on when they actually did go up.
He was too good for this.
But that day never came, obviously.
That day never came.
And what did that do to him? I mean...
It gradually destroyed him, I think.
Okay.
He deteriorated... Yeah, like I said, he drank a lot. He was full of self-recrimination, and so was I. Well, mainly from his influence. I caught it.
Okay.
From him.
And I'll tell a story about, I talked to him one last time before his death, and he made me promise to get this news out. It was too great. It was, you know, this, yeah, one last story.
I died before him.
Okay. One last conversation that. Right? The last conversation you had was about 3 months ago. And he said that, you know, he's going to write a letter and put it in a drawer, and maybe his wife someday will give it out. But he's like, Eric Stanley, you know, you're a media guy. You got to tell the truth one day, you know, right before. But he urged me to tell the truth. You know, he couldn't because of reasons that because he was a government employee his whole life and he had a government pension, and here I am, a millionaire, like, you know, you can afford to, Stanley, tell the truth. You know, I still get a government pension, you know what I'm saying? And that's been eating on you to do this. And that's why you're not doing it now. You're doing it 15 years from now. You know, or whenever. Like, in other words, you're telling this. That's why you're not announcing on CNN. It's because you're going to honor his wish. But you're not ready for it now to come out. But this is, you're doing this for
now. Why am I putting it off? Because I think I'll be...
Because you don't want your family... You want to be dead.
Right.
And you don't want your family to have 15 years on it. Your wife will probably be dead, and your kid will be grown.
Right.
You want distance from your legacy, from this truth. That's it.
Okay. Right.
So, what happened... So what really motivated contacting me as a filmmaker was I talked to Neil, okay, and I really felt guilty, and that's why I arranged for you to interview me, because I wanted to dip a boat.
I'm sorry.
Okay, so you did 11 and 13. Why 13? Why did you make 13 and do like a failure? Why did you?
Because 12 was a disaster. I mean,
what do you mean? Why?
Did it? 72. By then, it was old hat almost. People just didn't care. And that's why they had to play golf up there.
Okay, so...
I mean, as if golf was watchable.
Okay.
I mean, if they'd had a horse race, that would have been watchable.
That's true.
But a golf match, I mean, a golf game on the moon...
Right. Okay, so they weren't getting the ratings.
That wasn't my idea. I will not take credit for that.
Okay, so it was really a ratings issue. That if they 12 didn't pull the ratings that 11 did. And so why did you come up with 13 storyline? Like, how'd that happen?